Thank you guys for paying attention and being strong throughout this day. We again appreciate the economic assistance of my colleagues, David and Lamont. Just to wrap it up before we get out of here, I know the last presenter for you guys is, I know you probably have other things going on, but hopefully what you've been hearing is very informative, it's very reflective, but most of all, it's fruitful. So, talking about fruit, I want to kind of reshape your focus. And what I want to say is that, first of all, everybody is fruit. I look at everybody as fruit. And I know a lot of times people say, do you look at everybody as fruit? And I say, yeah, part of it is because I'm a big guy, I like to eat. All right, so I'm thinking about food. But the second part of it is there's actually an analogy behind that. And what I mean by fruit is this, like think about fruit. Every type of fruit you like has one or two processes. Either it's peeled or it's picked. It's peeled or picked. So my favorite fruit is orange. You have to peel it. Some people's favorite fruit might be a strawberry. You have to pick it. But the thing about fruit is this. The essence of the fruit is never to be enjoyed by the fruit itself. It's supposed to be enjoyed by the world or someone who's partaking in the fruit. So when I say that you're fruit, that means that you have something in you that is beneficial to the world that you're given. You have some kind of nourishment inside of you that is beneficial. So whatever your fruit is, going back to me, mine's the orange, you provide nourishment to your society, to your neighborhood, to your community, to your family. But here's the trick about the fruit that we don't often think about. Fruit has to go through the peeling or picking process. We don't like to be peeled sometimes. And what's that analogy of being peeled? The analogy of being peeled sometimes is going through life storms, going through trials and tribulations. And that's that peeling. It's constantly refining who you are to get to that fruit. So sometimes you think that you've done enough, but you're still peeling away because we need to get to the essence of who you are, number one. Now, taking that same aspect of peeling, when you go through those trials, troubles, and tribulations, those are called storms. But the good thing about a storm is this. Storms are never designed to be stationary. Storms are designed to always be moving. So there's three things that always happen to any individual. Either you're getting ready to go into the storm, you're currently in the storm, or you're coming out of the storm. See, everybody has problems. Everybody has situations they're going through. Right now, you don't know what I'm going through as an individual. But at the same time, the people in here, you don't know what they're doing outside of life. You don't know what's going on mentally, physically, emotionally, family, whatever. The stresses in life that we have to deal with. But the good thing about it is this. Every storm has to move. So again, I said, you're either going into a storm, you're currently in a storm, or you're ready to head out of a storm. So be mindful that as these storms help define who you are, storms also help clean up the atmosphere. And why does that kind of look like the fruit? Well, the storms help us make sure that we're purifying the essence of the fruit that's inside of you. So I'll go back and say, I like to use a lot of analogies. So I'll use another analogy. You see the screen behind me? It's a pretty big screen. So let's do a thought process. Number one, let's think of a caterpillar. A caterpillar is something that's real small and moves real short. And on looks at the day-to-day things, right? So it's really it's just looking at the ground before it, and it's taking a long time to get to the spot. So reflect your thought to yourself right now and say, if I had a caterpillar and it had to crawl in a straight line from this end of the screen to that end of the screen, how long would it take? Take a couple seconds and think about that. How long would that caterpillar take to go from one side of the screen to the other? Most people will say it takes 30 minutes, 45 minutes, an hour maybe. All right? Now, what is that caterpillar doing? There's a few things that we're talking about that caterpillar is doing. Number one, the caterpillar is constantly doing this. It's constantly eating. Why is it eating? Because if we know the process of metamorphosis, it has to be ready for cocoon stage. So it's constantly eating. But there's some restrictions for that caterpillar. A caterpillar can only see what's in front of it. And it moves very slow. So it doesn't get the opportunity to take around this stadium, this atmosphere, and to see the people around. It can only deal with what's in front of it. Now, a caterpillar comes into a decision, the very first important decision. It has to decide does it want to change. Because, like fruit, it has the potential to be something else inside of it. But it has to decide does it want to do that. So once a caterpillar decides it wants to be cocooned, It uses the knowledge. See, that eating process is kind of like what you're going through. You're going through life's ups and downs. You're going through storms. You're going to classes and you're taking notes and you're studying and trying to figure out how this is applicable to my life. That's all that eating process, because like a caterpillar, it seems really slow. It seems redundant. It might not seem important, might not seem fruitful in the long term, but it becomes something that helps protect you. Because when that caterpillar decides to go into a cocoon stage, that's when the metamorphosis and the change starts to happen, right? Because we know that caterpillar has the opportunity to become what? A butterfly. So it goes into the cocoon stage. Now here's something that will pause that conversation. Think about this caterpillar in the cocoon stage, but the thing about the cocoon stage is this, it's the point of isolation. See, we understand a caterpillar cannot be cut out of a cocoon. You'll kill it. A caterpillar has to decide on its own, the second wave of decision. It has to decide on its own whether that's going to break out and become a butterfly. Right? So here's the thing about the caterpillar, and what some of you guys have to go through right now is in the storm. So when you're in that storm, you're being cased around chaos and things going on. And so what I would say is, there was a wonderful young lady who gave me a really wonderful message about the five senses, and I want to share that with you guys today. And so when you're in a cocoon stage, remember these five senses. Guard your five senses. Guard your five senses. What do I mean by that? Guard, when you're in that part of isolation, when you're in storm, here we go. Number one, guard what you hear. Sometimes we let negativity get to us because we're constantly hearing negative stuff. Guard what you hear when you're in that storm. Number two, guard what you see. Because remember I told you, storms are designed to constantly move. So at that point, you might just see darkness, you might see chaos, you might be seeing debris flying around like if you're in a tornado or whatever the case may be. But guard what you see, because you have to have the vision and foresight to understand there's joy, there's sunshine, there's peace outside of the storm. Number three, guard what you touch. What I mean by that is guard what you hang around. Some of the most negative people that can do the most damage to you are the ones that's closest to you. You're going to inevitably be hurt by more people that look like you and that act like you than people who don't. So guard what you hang around. Number four, guard what you're ingesting and what you smell. So those two are all together. So guard what we're taking into ourselves. So are we taking care of our bodies? All right? Are we saying right things? Are we using our sense of discernment to understand when we should study more and say no to the party? When we should focus on our learning this particular method in class? Are we still going to go hang out with our spouses or our significant others? So you have to guard your senses, because the enemy will always try to first attack the five senses. If it can get into one of your five senses, then it can mess you up. Think about the Adam and Eve. What happened in that story in the Bible, where Adam and Eve is the five senses that attacked. The first thing that happened was, Satan asked her, do you truly believe what the Lord said? Number one, he attacked her hearing. Number two, he showed her an apple. Then she took the apple, so she ate it. But before she could eat the apple, she had to touch it. Once your five senses are taken over, you're more susceptible to go down the wrong path. So when you're in that cocoon stage where it seems like there's a storm or there's something's going wrong, guard your senses. Because it's only what you have that you've taken in that can preserve it. Okay? So guard your senses. So when that caterpillar decides to break out on its own accord and it can't be cut out, it becomes a butterfly. Do we agree with that? Comes a butterfly? Caterpillar butterfly? No, I'm not asking. Do we agree with that?
Yeah.
I just shaking my head. So I'm saying, when that becomes a butterfly, now let's go back to this thought process. We asked earlier, how long does it take a caterpillar to cross from this side of the screen to this side of the screen over here? Some people say 35 minutes, some people say an hour, some people say an hour and a half. But now the question is, how long will it take a butterfly to fly from this side of the screen to this side of the screen? See, it only takes about a couple of seconds. Assuming that the butterfly flies in a straight line, okay? It only takes a couple of seconds, no more than 15 seconds. So what's the moral of that? We all start from caterpillars, but we all have the potential to be butterflies. We all have fruit in us. We all have the potential to be something great. See, what I believe is when I deal with young men, when I deal with students and college students, when I go speak all across this country, when I go speak across the world, this is what I tell people. Everybody is a genius. You just gotta be in the right environment. See, a shark naturally knows what to do in the ocean, but it looks foolish out in the jungle. A lion naturally knows what to do in the jungle, but it looks foolish up in the air. But when you're in your natural environment, there's a flow that comes out. It's effortless. You don't have to fight it. So find your natural genius, because everybody has a genius in them. And follow it with passion and purpose. Don't let other people tell you what your vision is, but know what you envision. See, because your vision comes from within. So know what you envision about yourself. Because everybody has the potential to become a caterpillar to a butterfly. Because everybody, like I said before, has fruit in them. Take this time to make sure you guard your senses, turn yourself into a butterfly, and remember, all storms are designed to move and not be stationary. Thank you.